I like hearing the sound of your voice because it sounds like football. Mm-hmm. You and your brother both have that Ohio. Whereabouts in Ohio is it from? Northeast Ohio?
Well, yeah, I kind of grew up in Indiana. I was born in Ohio, but I was an infant when we moved. Grew up in Bloomington, Indiana, South Bend, Indiana, and then went to high school in Tampa.
There you go. You've got that football voice. And the first time we sat down with Coach McVay, we were like, you try to sound like a Gruden sometimes. You grew up around
the
Gruden.
Yeah.
That's
what
I was saying.
Copycat. Yeah. We got that trademarked. He can't have it.
Do you remember first meeting him and he sounded completely normal and then slowly morphed into a Gruden?
He didn't talk a lot when I first met him. He was really young. He was like John's little office manager, kind of just typed up scripts and all that stuff. He came up the hard way now. He went on a fast track and did a great job, but didn't talk a whole lot when I first met him.
Right. So a guy like that, when you see him and you meet him and you see what he's doing, do you have any inkling that, like, this guy's head coach material? Can you tell even when a guy comes in the door the first day?
You never really can't tell until they get in front of players and how they interact with players and how they get across what they need to get across in a professional manner to get the players to do what they're supposed to do. And Sean's great at that. You know, he's a very young-looking individual, but once he talks football, the players have a lot of respect for him because his knowledge is great.
Mm-hmm.
You gain respect with the knowledge that you have and the ability to get across to the players. You know, I coach Chris Cooley. Chris Cooley has nothing but great things to say about him, and he moved on from tight end coach to obviously offensive coordinator with me. People said I was crazy hiring this young offensive coordinator.
Yeah.
Now they say I'm an idiot. They're an idiot for letting them go. So,
yeah.
You know, that's just where you guys are
that
in
is
the media,
how the NFL
right?
Works. Yeah. Yeah.
It is kind of funny that way. So now you're down in Jacksonville. We were talking to Doug Marrone earlier. He said that one of the first things you mentioned was we need to get a fullback. I'm a big fullback guy. We're a pro fullback podcast.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems like you want to introduce that wrinkle back to Jacksonville because they used to have, Bohannon back in the day. Have you thought about who that individual might be?
No. There's some free agents out there you can look at. There's some guys in the draft possibly. You know, it's not a necessity to have a fullback, but that part of your offense, when you take that out of your game, you know, there's some pretty good plays that you're missing. You know, play action passes are excellent. Obviously, the running game can improve a little bit, but to have a good fullback goes hand in hand. You better have a good tight end that can block the edge as well. So, you know, we're trying to figure out the necessary pieces to our offense so we can come at and we can really have a feel really good grasp of where we want to go. Fullback, tight end, two tight ends, three tight ends, one tight end, you know what I mean? So we're still in the infantry stages, but we'll figure it out.
How do you pick up new wrinkles to your offense? Do you just do through watching college, through watching other coaches? Like, what's
that process? Yeah, both, really. You know, it's fun when you go and you start to evaluate these players for the draft. I always got an idea reel, something I haven't seen before, and I click them on there and I store them, and I always go back to them to help just try to spark a thought. And then obviously watching teams that are successful. Watch what the 49ers did this year with their fullback, for instance. And watch, obviously, Patrick Mahomes play with Kansas City. I always like to watch Sean because we have similar type things, but he's branched off and done some different things himself. So there's about 7 or 8 teams that I like to watch and study and come up with good ideas.
Mm-hmm. So if it was a battle royale, your brother and Sean.
Me.
Wait. Let me finish. Actually, yeah, you're right. Because it was going to be your brother and Sean versus you and Deuce.
Ooh. Oh, Deuce. Me and Deuce.
I feel like Deuce is like your like attack dog.
How are you going to get Deuce out of the ring?
I rarely get starstruck. But when we were walking through the lobby last year at the Combine, it was this very lobby.
Mm-hmm.
It was like 9 o'clock p.m. and Deuce was grinding film just by himself at a table. And I was like, oh, my God, that's Deuce Gruden. That's incredible. That was like the
I might take Deuce's brother now. He's an MMA fighter.
Really?
He's
my God.
3-0 right now. He's jacked up, too.
Wow. I was doing a little research on your family, and it's you and John, but then you have another brother.
Yeah.
Who's a doctor?
Yeah,
he's
like a smart
black
one.
Sheep of the family. Like,
what's up with that?
Some people run away to join the circus.
I was the youngest brother of three, and those two guys, you couldn't draw up two exact opposite human beings to be brothers. Really? Jim is smart. John was a jock, and they butted heads a lot and argued and fought. And I was always a mediator. I just want to play, you know.
Uh-huh.
But ultimately, they figured out and got along, and everybody gets along good.
So, does he watch all your guys' games? Does he come and see games during the season, or is he kind of?
Yeah, he comes. He's come before. He's pretty busy himself, though.
Yeah.
But he got up to the Giants game and he came to a home game for me last year, and so he tries to come as much as he can.
That'd be cool if he had, like, some random plays that he gave you. He was, like, the Gruden whisperer. Because he's a doctor at Cornell, right?
Yeah, he's a radiologist. Yeah,
yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, he's that's wild. Mm-hmm.
Jay just gave you this look like, yeah, are you stalking me?
Yeah, what's going on?
You know everything about my family?
Yeah. Well, I think I uncovered the secret. I think he has the best plays. He gives them to you. So if we can get to those plays.
We did used to play board games all the time, college football, the right dolt, roll the dice and pick plays and stuff. And Jim and I used to play that all the time. He's a pretty good play caller.
Yeah. Okay.
Are you playing against the Raiders this year?
No.
That'd be awesome.
Damn.
The Bruin Bowl. And your brother could show up wearing like a half visor, half Jacksonville, half black.
And I could wear my headset all crooked.
That would be good.
That'd be awesome.
Did you watch Hard Knocks?
I did watch part of it, yeah.
What'd you think?
I thought it was pretty good. You know, we're in training camp as well, so I could, like, after meetings and stuff, I'd click it on. It was pretty good.
Did you think your brother was maybe, like, kind of turning it up a little for the cameras?
He wouldn't do that. He doesn't play to the cameras. Of course he did. That's the way he is, really.
Yeah.
He coaches with a lot of energy, a lot of passion, and a great motivator. So, yeah, he's the way he is.
Was it ever awkward when he was in media and he had to call your games and it's like...
I never listen to games. I don't listen to media.
Okay.
Really. I really don't. I try not to, and unless it comes to my attention that somebody says something really bad that I have to address or show something really bad. But, yeah, I just try to do my own thing and...
It's a nice way to live, just to be kind of like not listen to anything.
Go crazy.
Yeah.
What I have done before is really bad now. Some of the articles, I've scrolled down and read the comments.
Oh, yeah.
You can't do that.
Who writes those things?
You can't do
that. I want to meet some of these comment writers.
You can't do that.
It's assholes. Unbelievable.
The comments like,
Have you ever read the Pro Football Talk comment section?
Unbelievable.
Yeah. The worst place on the planet. Absolutely. Like,
who writes those things?
Yeah. Probably psychos. Mass murderers.
Psychos.
Probably people that should be locked
some
up.
Some are pretty
in
funny, though.
Jail.
Yeah,
some of them are really.
You gotta be able to laugh at
that's
yourself.
That's a good point. Some of them are really good.
It strikes me as guys who are like overcompensating for something, maybe height or whatever it may be.
You
see those comments.
Sometimes.
You want to be humbled? Yeah. Read a comment.
Yeah.
That's right.
True. That's a great quote. Put that on a quote.
Yeah. Point.